So let that be a lesson to you. Just because that breaker wasn't tripped, I'm here on this chiller call. We got an A200, which means that upon start commands, the chiller did not see flow on the flow sensor within, I think it's like 3 or 5 minutes, or it's so much, they've got so much time to establish the flow sensor before it trips an A200. Now, and I went in and I enabled the chiller, and I've got Teams here where I can log in remotely. And I can control it from here, reset it. Right now you see the purple, I've got it commanded into an on. And I lowered the chill water set point just to force it on, because they've got it running like 58 to maintain the building, which is fine. It's really cool out. They don't really need much cooling. This chiller is set up to control the pump itself. And that little lightning bolt on that upper pump, that is the pump 2 for this chiller. And these are dedicated pumps. My lightning bolt never lit. I never heard the pump engage. I'm really wondering. I think we got some, maybe something at the pump. Maybe our output here going to the pump has an issue. We need to go check that out now. I'm gonna cycle this. It does nothing. Cycle down. This is the current transducer that is notifying the automation that the pump actually engaged. This here is the control relay coming from the chiller that turns the pump off and on, but that is bypassed by this HOA. We've got a blown fuse, we got something in here that's not right. So reading between L1 and L2, I've got absolutely nothing. That 12 volts is not legitimate. Moving over to L3. Same, and we're gonna slide in here, and the same. Okay, so we've lost main power coming into this disconnect, which we've had. This is an older motor. This motor got replaced because it was starting to get weak on the windings. We may have a similar issue here. Regardless, we do not have power coming into this disconnect, which that pipes to over here. Chill water pump 2 is 31 33 35, right there. Okay, well, that's interesting. Now this is supposed to be the pump's power, and we have a trip indicator. Is not tripped. It shows we have power. Just because it's not showing tripped, we're going to go ahead and shut it down, make sure it's fully closed, go back to on. So let that be a lesson to you. Just because that breaker wasn't tripped, it was not sending power through. We're at 486 now. 483. All right, so we got all three legs now. That breaker doesn't look old visibly, and we do have an overload. And most of the time when you have a situation where you end up tripping the main breaker to it before the overload ever trips, it's typically something pretty significant. I would venture to say we're about to test it, but I'm probably going to get the megger. We may need to meg this motor, even if it ohms okay to ground. So let's cycle over to ohms. I'm going to leave it in auto range. And one way you'll know, it goes to cycles between those readings and then lands at millions of ohms. That's how you know you got it good. All right, that leg checks good. All the legs are checking good with regular ohms. I need to go get my megger out of the truck, and we're going to put a megger on this. We got our leads hooked up. And I got it switched over to 1,000 volts. We're gonna get this rolling. So honestly, those are good numbers. Now I would much prefer to see this spike above, you know, my range, which is 2 billion. You see how we're steadily increasing, and we're on the incline. That's a really good thing. Now I'm gonna continue to watch it to make sure that it doesn't start to stabilize and then come back down. But it is possible. Now this motor is completely cold, so it is possible that once it heats up, you know, that number could change. But even if that were the case, I wouldn't expect it to drop that much. I think it's more likely we just have some kind of power blip or some other issue. They weren't having issues with this for a long time, but then suddenly it just starts, you know, tripping out like it was. I wonder if that switch even works. So these control fuses are blown. I got that far. It's actually the first thing I pulled out. I did confirm we had the 24 volts input. Now those fuses, if I remember correctly, should over on the primary side. So we need to ohm this transformer out and see what's going on with it. We have 43 ohms. They don't show anything to ground. Now, I don't know what the actual ohms value is supposed to be on this. I tell you, today is my day, guys. I actually have a little bag of half-inch fuses. Oh, that one's a quarter. But a little half-inch fuse is in my truck. To verify the 43, I pulled up the spec data on that transformer. I looked at the little model number there, and I could not pull a spec on the coils. But I did compare it to this starter, which has an identical setup, and it was running just a couple of ohms more. This was 43, this was 46. It's close enough, I'm comfortable with moving forward. So, and I'm really sitting here wondering, okay, so something happened that we blew the main and we popped those fuses. What would have really caused that? And ultimately, the only thing that answers that would be like a brownout, because it's on the primary side of that coil. And for us to trip that as well, just the motor probably tripped that during the brownout, and at the same time just had to have been because the voltage on the phases dropped out like it did. It's the only thing that makes sense. We'll flip the auto, and what do you know, we turn on. Now I'm going to verify rotation, take my Sharpie. Yep, rotation is proper. Yes, sir. We want to spin this way to flow. All right. The motor megged perfectly fine. It sounds fine. I don't hear any bearing issues. If you don't know, anytime you run a test mode on these, you always have to put it in the off position first, and then you can cycle over. So I'll show you how that looks. I want to run a test on the pump. What I would need to do is whether it's either one of these, whether you run local or run remote, you want to switch to off, and you'll cycle down to service test menu. You're going to hit enter, test, you're going to enter again, you're going to move it to on, enter. Now you have officially established it. If it does not hold, it's going to cycle this back to off. That's how you know it didn't work. Now you can go down to like outputs, and then I can drive the EXVs. I could also drive the different fans, or I can go to cooling pump one is in off. Now I can cycle back to enable and then hit enter on, and my pump turns on. And then when I'm done, enter again, go to off, off, escape, and then we'll go ahead and back all the way out. We'll back out of test mode because I'm done with that part. Yes, and we're going to go to remote because I want this to cycle on the automation. This should go into an occupied status. The pump turns on, I hear it. This should go through a circulate timer for a couple of minutes, and then we'll hear the fans ramp up and it'll start to stage on. And just like that, everything's rocking and rolling. The chiller's turned on, it's ramping up, doing like it's supposed to. And you can see even through the automation, it's reporting back. You can see the pump on the top left corner is now enabled. It's showing that it does have it on status. Everything's rocking. MTT, take care of your family, take care of your spouse, guys.